Turn the button on, Autumn. You gained it too much.
I'm recording now, though.
No, he's handed it to you.
Okay.
My reading from Michael Vanderpool.
On the Daemon Tarot, or the Daemon Tarot, and these are the cards in the spread, the first position for the La Carte Infernales Tarot deck here, as you can see another name for the same Tarot deck, the Daemon Tarot, Ronov. Ronov is your position as questioner, and it's transcribed as Ronov, or Ronov. It's a Marquise of Hell whose appearance is simply described by demonologists as monsters. He is a gifted speaker in command of 19 military units. So this is a person that can be very fierce, very scary if they want to be, and very militant. They can move people and move minds. They can get things done, actually.
And that's that you said that could, what'd you say, move things?
Move people, move minds.
Move minds.
Get things done. Yes.
My reading from Kathy McKenzie Hasty, she said, she says, I think you have telekinesis. You just haven't
developed it.
You're here.
Yeah.
I don't have a bottle. I'm looking for it.
In this position of number two,
there it is, right there.
This is Valak.
It's on. Hey. You're
the loss is a president of hell with 30 legions at his commands. He can take form of a beautiful child with the wings of an angel, and he rides a two-headed dragon. This is a card of defense, the best defense. So I guess it's to say, kind of like a former president, which one had talked about to speak softly but walk with a big stick.
Teddy Roosevelt.
And so the angel face of what is actually a two-headed dragon, or you know, the beautiful child with the wings of an angel riding a two-headed dragon, shows the you know, a kind of a front of innocence and coming off with childlike innocence and curiosity and balance about life, unprejudiced, if you will, but with the ability to literally take up with, you know, riding on the back of a two-headed dragon means that child could be quite destructive to its enemies. So that's your best defense, is to remember that sometimes it's necessary to use the power of a two-headed dragon. You know, you can't always be innocent and kind and childlike with people. Sometimes you have to be a double dragon.
And these
that's
are
your best defense.
And what have I been telling you? The sweet and innocent, you know, and being naive, and my days are over with that. Like, no.
And then the heart of the situation is represented by Bufonite.
Bufonite? I don't know what that is.
Bufonite, or toadstone, is a magical stone is said to grow within the head of a live toad. The stone harvested from a creature who was used as an ingredient in many poisons was said to be a powerful antidote. So it's, to me,
It's a frog.
It's speaking about the situation where
it's a poisonous frog.
You see
frog.
It as a difficult and toxic, you know, like you're dealing with something toxic, but in completing this and getting through this, you have come to a place of healing. And we
it's both true.
It's
a poisonous frog. It's yellow and it's orange and black.
It literally speaks of
it's
a powerful antidote.
I know what it's
powerful what?
Antidote.
Antidote.
And overcoming the poison.
Yeah.
But you're getting it from the toad. The stone harvested from a creature who was used as an ingredient.
Did you hear that?
It was said to be a powerful antidote.
A powerful antidote for overcoming poison. And I just finished my last pill today.
There you go.
Of a treatment that's almost killed many people.
Yeah.
It has killed some people. It killed one woman that I know.
I'm a soldier.
And the position of card number 4 is taking offense in the thing and thoughts or actions. So it's taking action in the offensive maneuvers in the situation to deal with what is perceived here as overcoming a place where you have had challenges with your health, and you've had success in that now as of today in finality. And so it's talking about your best actions now have to do with this Boar. This is the president of hell with 50 military units under his command. Demonographers describe him as either taking the shape of Sagittarius or having the head of a lion and 5 legs. So this to me is speaking about making some different habits in your life and looking and reevaluating where you're at with your new health and what you'll do to be not a person with challenged health, but a person who is born again. And this position, this card is number 4. Sorry, this is number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the 5th position, this is where you're heading. And it has the, it's brooms, the brooms card. There is a witch, obviously, on the brooms. So brooms are an old and powerful symbol and tool of witchcraft. They are traditional vehicles for magical travel, essential elements of various rituals, and useful for sweeping up dust. So it's kind of like cleaning up your life, maybe going to travel different, even if it's just here or there, or anywhere, maybe. It's just...
She wants to go to Egypt.
And certainly that would fulfill it, but cleaning up in both the physical and in magical sense, you know, really.
That's more what I'm looking at it, is in the magical thing about the witches and the brooms and all that.
Magical travel and essential elements of various rituals, yeah. And yeah, that's definitely fits it. Now, this position of number 6, and of course this book on the Daemon Tarot gives the warning that you don't pick up number 6 and turn it over unless you're ready for the possibility of someone or something that is coming your way to help with the situation. And in my sense of this reading, my understanding is you're at a place where you're having a big shift in your life, or you can be not only in the physical but psychological as well, from going through a place of hell to a place of health and healing. And this position is Oribus. Oribus is a prince of hell who never lies. His true form is that of a horse, but he may manifest in human shape when summoned. There are 20 military units at his command. So what I perceive this to be, you're going from a place of self-deception, maybe even deception, deceiving others, to a place where you're going to be more truthful about you and your life, and you're a truth seeker now more than you were before. You're at a place of you've passed self-deception into truth.
Yeah, I'm not eluding myself about anything. So
that's the reading on that. Now, they can be done as a one-card draw to your question, answers to questions.
Okay.
On card draw.
I'm next. God, make it. Okay.
Do you have any particular question? Or just...
Define the question.
No, it's your question. What are you wanting to know? What are you wanting to ask?
I can't say that.
And then that makes sense to you.
I can't say that. I can say that with you two. Can't say that with you because I don't know you all that well.
You can trust him.
He's
alright. Huh?
You can trust him.
Am I gonna fucking live?
Let's see.
Done deal.
You're all like Autumn.
So in this reading,
But I have, like, more than one question. But, I mean, I guess I answered the first question, the first thing that popped in my head.
It'll explain different areas of your life.
Okay, go.
This represents the questioner in the position of the first card, which is Bauer. It says, Bauer is the president of hell with 50 military units under his command. Demonographers describe him as either taking the shape of Sagittarius or having the head of a lion and five legs. Well, it can be that because of pride, the inability to move on things that would help your situation, but...
Your own pride, baby.
Shut up.
Sometimes not listening to yourself or others' advice because sometimes you think you're more smarter than everyone else. So pride...
Oh, my motherfucking God.
Pride would be part of it.
Oh, seriously.
And then on this position,
he just fucking slapped your ass.
I'm so sorry. I just got hit.
You did. You got that. I felt that.
Somebody hit me in the face. Right, go on, go on. I'm sorry, dude. I'm sorry.
I was preparing myself to rebuttal just in case he tried to deny it.
I'm sure you were, but I got this.
Go on.
In the position of the second card is the best defense for the situation. And this is represented by Bophonite, the toadstone. We just read this one. It's a magical
stone. I know what
toadstone
is.
Said to grow within the head of a live toad. The stone, harvested from a creature who was used as an ingredient in many poisons, was said to be a powerful antidote. So, again, it's looking deeply into the situation, which is a kind of a very toxic... It's a place that's killing you with situationally speaking. So in order to get out of that, you've got to find what is good in it and extract that and move on with it, but leave the toxic people and thinking behind.
Or bottle.
In the heart of the situation is the card Brooms. So in the heart of the situation, brooms are an old and powerful symbol, a tool of witchcraft. They are traditional vehicles for magical travel, essential elements of various rituals, and useful for sweeping up dust. So again, it's kind of like using this insight to clean up your life, clean out the dust, clean out the dirt. And you can move forward and just be considering travel too, even if it's local parks or getting to the city or something. And the third position is the best way to take action, thoughts toward offensive action, making offense. And this is represented by Amon. Amon is...
I knew who Amon is.
Possibly related to Egyptian Amun.
No.
It is a fire-breathing marquee of hell. He has the body and teeth of a wolf.
I know who
Amon
is.
The tail of a serpent and the head of an owl. So it's being... wise, fierce, defensive, taking care of yourself, not to let anybody, and going out. Teeth of a wolf suggests being ravenous like a wolf, moving forward like you're hungry as a wolf.
He is absolutely fucking headed for you, and he will devour you. I know who Amon is.
It's like moving forward like you're hungry as a wolf.
He moves forward, and he just absolutely devours you.
Well, I think it's telling you, you need to... devourously
move forward like
move forward.
A hungry wolf.
You need to just move forward and fuck everything else.
And this fifth position is going to be where the situation is heading in total. This is represented by Behemoth, which is the lord of gluttony and the high cupbearer of hell, but some demonologists claim he's nothing more than a terrible but simple beast. He may look like an elephant or some extinct creature. So it speaks about gluttony and
Will you stop right there?
Drinking
too much.
Will
you stop right there?
Cupbearer of hell.
No gluttony.
You're gluttonously drinking.
No, I fucking had gastric bypass because
yes.
I ate so fucking much that I got gained 430 pounds.
You should see the picture.
Picture is horrifying.
And
so I had gastric bypass. So that was gluttony on me.
Interesting.
Do you want to turn over the last card?
Go, Oh,
in the sixth position is the card that represents...
Now, are you sure you're wanting somebody to come help you?
Huh?
Are you sure you want this red?
Yes.
Okay, because this is going to represent... What
who
is
can
it?
Help you?
Go!
Who will come?
Quit.
Who can and will?
Quit and go.
Okay.
Quit and go.
So, from Le Cartes Infernales Tarot card, in this position, who is coming or who he can go to for help is Ukubot. It's not one of the ruling class in hell. He is charged with maintaining the oil and the boilers of the underworld, and it's claimed
it
that
is
he should be credited with the invention of fried food.
What?
He's credited with the invention of fried food.
A chef.
Yeah, it talks about boiling oil and fried food. The chef.
Yes.
A chef is going to show up?
Yeah.
A cook or a chef.
Fast
food.
A chef is going to save him.
Fast
only
food.
Only he
chef.
Can save himself. He is a chef.
That is so stupid.
It's
absolutely
that's what
true.
I say. He's
true.
A fucking chef. He's got a fucking
fried
addiction.
Food and boilers.
It's pride stopping him, and he has to save himself, basically, or he's going
because
to die.
Because I could cook better than any man, any person in this entire world.
Do you do a lot of fried foods with oil?
No, I just cook food. But I can fry food. I can do food. I can make food out of... Added something, added nothing. Just give me some food, and I will fucking make sure everybody's fed.
So long.
And I feed everybody all my life. I feed everybody.
Ron, your question was, am I going to live? This is telling you that you still have a chance to change your path, and you only you can save
what's
yourself.
The point? What's the
if
point?
If you don't, then you won't have a future.
You'll become an extinct creature, as it says.
So I'll be just dead.
It says you can still save yourself. Mm-hmm. But if you don't try, then you'll be dead.
Well, that's my decision.
No,
you're poisoning yourself.
Maybe it's my decision.
You need to travel somewhere to save yourself.
What the fuck? Why don't I travel?
That's what the cards say.
I have traveled all my life.
Basically, you're not going to be able to save yourself sitting at home. It's not going to work. You have to go somewhere.
What's the point? You go,
saving your life?
I go somewhere else, somewhere this...
Follow me. and feel infinity, eternity. Follow me and feel. Follow me.